The Porter Wagoner Show, starring Porter Wagoner and the Wagon Masters, with Speck Rhodes, Norma Jean, and special guest star, Charlie Walker.
Hello there,
Where's sitting there, heavy? You know, I'm proud of you this time. With our guest on this time, Charlie Walker, it's going to make you look real heavy.
Yeah, it whistle blowing?
Yes, Dad.
That's a fireball mail, baby.
I thought you was hinting for me to leave.
Thank you very much, and howdy, everybody. It looks like this is going to be a good one. T's already got me tickled on the first number. He said he forgot to tell the folks who I was. Well, I'm Porter Wagoner, and we're certainly glad to have you with us here in the old wagon house. We've got Miss Norma Jean, Don, and Speck, and Jack, Buck. All of them are all been practicing for quite a spell, getting ready, and we hope you'll have just as half as much fun as we will. I'm going to tell you, that's fine, man.
Thank you.
T's waving the white flag at you, wasn't he?
I'm going to tell you one thing. That thing won't never get well the way he's picking.
He likes my picking about like I like his announcement.
I know it, man. You both of you are good fans of each other's, and that's mighty fine. T told Buck a while ago, said that never will get well. You keep picking it like that, and that's the truth, too. You know, here's a fellow that's our guest today that is one of my favorite singers and also one of my favorite people. A fellow that a good golfing buddy of mine and a guy that shared the stage of the Grand Ole Opry many times. Comes from out in San Antonio, Texas, and he's one of the real good ones, too. Mr. Poke Salad, Charlie Walker. Yeah. Come on, guys. Charlie, it's good to see you and have you with us, man.
Wonderful. It's certainly nice to be with you, too.
I know that your golf game's good, so we won't need to talk about that because you beat me the last time we played. How's the singing business? I know you've been working a lot, haven't you?
Well, it's been wonderful, yeah. We've been making the different parts of the country in the last few months.
You've done one of the old ones here. You got one picked out that will remember you for quite a while back, won't we?
I'd like to start off with that one, Paul, if you don't mind. It's called Pick Me Up on Your Way Down. You were mine for just a while. Now you're putting on the style. And you've never once looked back at your home across the track. You're the gossip of the town, but my heart can still be found where you tossed it on the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down when you're blue and all alone. When their glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but they'll find another toy. Then they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down. They have changed your attitude, made you haughty and so rude. Your new friends can take the blame. Underneath, you're still the same. When you learn these things are true, I'll be waiting here for you as you tumble to the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down when you're blue and all alone. When their glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but they'll find another toy. Then they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down.
Fine. Fine, man. Real fine. That's one of the real big tunes you did, too. Listen, I was just thinking, you know, a lot of folks always have nicknames, and of course I've heard you nickname Poke Salad Walker down around San Antonio. How'd you ever get a nickname of that? Is it because you like the old poke salad?
I guess so, Porter. Yeah, I was about half raised on poke salad, you know, when I was a boy, so.
Well, I'll tell you, I was too. Poke salad, gravy, and beans. What'd you say over here?
And let's don't forget I used to call it Black Draw. Let's don't forget the Black Draw, too, if you don't mind us saying that.
Well, thank you very much, Charlie. And why don't you come back in a little bit and do another song for us?
Thank you very much.
Do a newer one, man. Good to have you with us. Right now, here's a little gal that's all prettied up today. As usual, I reckon if I was casting my vote for one of the prettiest girl singers in the business, I'd have to vote for our own pretty Miss Little Norma Jean. Come out here, young lady, and sing us a good song.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Porter. Here's an oldie, one called Just a Little Lovin'. Make my dream come true. Your eyes, your lips, your love.
Thank you very much. You know, that's real pretty singing. Miss Norma Jean, let's you and I do a duet, okay?
Okay, I've been wanting to do this one for a long time.
All righty. So
let me get on the other side.
You want to get over here? Okay.
I don't like that guitar.
And this is one we have in an album Skeeter Davis and I recorded called The Violet and the Rose. Favorites, and we hope you like it.
Like,
here's a couple of boys that's pictures in there. Beyond our control. Of course, I'm only kidding you. But they're sitting over here on the hay. Let's see what's happening with Speck and T, I think's with him.
All right,
that's quite a story.
I was just thinking about, you know, I went to an old-fashioned country play party the other night, too.
You did?
Yeah, they had one right here in Skunk Holler, and everybody in the whole country come out. Well, I went a little early.
You went a little early, did
you? Yeah,
yeah. What time did you get there?
Well, I got there before supper, you know, to get there time to eat.
Yeah.
Right after supper, you know, right after supper, we settled down to serious party game playing.
Some real Shona party
game. We just played party game after party game after party game after party game, and pleased or displeased, and go around the house with the girls and stuff and everything, you know.
Yeah.
It was all about midnight, see. It was all about midnight while we come down to the old kissing game.
Oh, I guess you like that, didn't you, Spec?
That's what I went out there for. it wasn't fair, though.
What?
No, sir, it wasn't a bit fair in the world.
How come?
You know what they done?
What did they do?
They hemmed every one of us guys there at the party. They hemmed us all up in the bedroom.
Yeah.
And when they got us in there, they tied blindfolds on us. And they got us blindfolded where we couldn't see nothing. They turned the women in on us.
Oh, now, that don't hardly seem fair to me. There ought to be something done about that.
Well, yeah.
Give you all a little
advantage. They got to pick on us good-looking guys. See, whoever the girl picked, why, he had to kiss her.
Oh, I see.
Of course, if he didn't want to kiss her, well, he could give her a dollar, and he wouldn't have to, you know.
If you didn't care about kissing, just give her a buck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My girl made $75 last night.
They got me some.
We spent it on the way home.
Then
after that, and they played another.
What other?
Another kissing game.
Did this one?
Yeah, but this one, man, I'm telling you, this one cost money.
Cost money?
I reckon it did. You know what they done? Girls from 14 to 18 years old, they charged you $2.50 to even kiss them.
Good grace alive. That is expensive.
I reckon it is. Mm-hmm. Of course, now girls from 18 to 24, they just charge $1 to kiss them.
Oh, well, that still cost too much money, Speck.
Yeah, it did. I didn't have but a quarter is all I had.
Oh, well, I guess that let you plumb out of the game, didn't it?
No.
It didn't?
No, you know, baby.
Old maids?
Yeah, old maids is 2 bits a dozen.
2 bits a dozen.
And I just got me a quarter's worth of old maids and smooched all night.
Neighbors, here's a song that we've had a lot of requests for, which we repeat some of them because you write and ask us to, and we're always thankful and real happy to hear from you. And here's one that you've asked for, called The Family Bible. There's a family Bible on the table. Its pages torn and hard to read. But the family Bible on the table will ever be my key. At the end of day, when work was over, and when the evening meal was done, Dad would read to us from the family Bible. And we'd count our many blessings one by one. I can see us sitting round the table when from the family Bible Dad would read. I can hear my mother softly singing, Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, fret for me, fret for me. This old world of ours is full of trouble. This old world would also better be if we had more Bible on the table and mother singing, Rock of Ages, clip for me. I can see a set the table when from the family Bible Dad would read. I can hear my mother softly singing, Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, thank you, little Jack and Don, for helping me out, and certainly hope that you enjoyed that one. Today, our guest star is a fellow that, like we said a while ago, we've known for a long time and one of the top entertainers around the country. Let's get him to come back out here again, Mr. Charlie Walker. Charlie, it's always good to see you, and especially to have you with us on our TV show.
It's always good to see you, Porter, and it's always a lot of fun to get you out on a golf course, too, you know.
Are you? Yeah. This guy is one of the real terrific golfers, and he's, of course, is a terrific singer, too. And when we get together, we talk about golf and picking and singing. Charlie, what you got for us this time, man?
Well, I tell you, let me do one of our newest Columbia records for you now, Porter.
All right. This is a good
our
one.
Very newest release. It's called Life Goes On. The day you left, I felt so strange. I thought for sure that the world would change, but the birds still sing and babies still cry, and life goes on. I wonder why an old love dies, but nobody cares. The world just minds its own affairs. The winner smiles and the losers cry, and life goes on. I wonder why. How can that moon that promised so much still show his face at night? And the birds that are singing ought to start crying whenever I walk inside. I sit here and cry as lovers stroll by, reminding me about you and I. They live to love while I live to die. And life goes on, I wonder why. How can that moon that promised so much still show his face at night? And the birds that are singing ought to start crying whenever I walk inside. I sit here and cry as lovers stroll by, reminding me about you and I. They live to love while I live to die. And life goes on, I wonder why.
Johnny, that's awful good, man. Thanks a lot for being our guest today.
Thank you. Wonderful job. Thank you so much, Porter. Really enjoyed it.
I want you to listen. This boy over on the telephone, Specs, got something he wants us to listen to. Let's watch.
Now, hello, Sadie. Hook me up down Doc Brown drugstore. Yeah. Life goes on, I wonder why. Do. Hello, Doc. How you feeling, sir? Well, I'm surprised at you. Yeah, if it's minor pains of arthritis and rheumatism at the bottom, you ought to know how a thorn brings you that wonderful temporary relief. After all, you said it. What's that? Oh, you done sold out. Well, the next time you order, just order more. But in the meantime, I'll loan you my two. Yeah. Okay, Doc. Goodbye. I'll bring it down. Hi, sir. Wonderful stuff.
This has been the Porter Wagoner Show, a half hour of good old country music and fun featuring Porter Wagoner and the Wagon Masters with Speck Rose, Norma Jean, and our special guest this time, Charlie Walker.